afternoon. This a brand new series we want to start now. For the past years, last year and up to last time, we have been telling you why you must be in business, why you must become an entrepreneur, that there are no jobs now all over the world. There are no jobs. And the government is not supposed to be employers. The government is supposed to create an environment in which the private sector can thrive and create jobs. It is the private sector that creates rich jobs. Government jobs don't add value to the economy. So when we talk of job creation, it's not the people employed by civil service that job creation. And if civil service is our biggest employer, then we are in serious trouble. So we are talking about proper job creation. And we have come to the conclusion that a proper job creation can only be created by you becoming your own boss. You start as an SME. SME means small, medium-sized enterprises. Then from there you can grow. You start small and you grow big. And SMEs employ over 60-70% of the workers all over the world. And that's how most governments are doing everything to support SMEs. You might say, okay, what are these SMEs? It's small, medium-sized enterprises. There are some are micros. Micro are the ones that employ one or two persons. All those people selling smart cards on the street, bullet, oranges, all those money businesses, they are called micro businesses. Small is people that employ from between 5 to 150 and 250 employees. So you can imagine, ask yourself, how many people can employ more than 300 employees? People like banks, people like MTN, Glow, all those are the large companies. So any company that doesn't employ up to 300 or 250 employees is an SME. So most of us fall in that category. The market is in Lagos, in Alabama market, Wuse market, Brabant market, all these people that are the engine room of the economy and all are in this category SMEs. We also mentioned something about farming. Why farming is the thing now, since the oil is losing its value. And we have spent so much teaching you how to become a farmer, the benefit of being in the agribusiness, the type of business you can do as a farmer or in the agribusiness. We have also mentioned to you the value chain. But today, from popular demand, people have been saying that one of the biggest problems people have, they don't keep records. They have no books of business. I remember my mom was an illiterate, stack illiterate. And she was a trader, she traded all her life. And when she died, so many people that were all that the money is lost because one, she has no record keeping. Everything was in her brain. So anytime she goes to this school, they'll be arguing. Because she doesn't give them receipts, there's no documentary evidence. So you said social for you last year, it's a social amount, there's arguing. And as a small boy, I was going to talk with her mom to see how she draws her depth. And every time we go back, she's so sad that she said that she's cheating her. I said, Mom, how do you know that she's cheating? I said, Mom, it's because I know that I said this has paid. And she's saying shit. So, I mean, too, I was so small. I don't even know the relevance of bookkeeping or records keeping. I think maybe that was why I became a chartered accountant. Because I said, this is that's really hurting my mom. This account of bookkeeping, I must dig into the bottom line. And today, thank God, I'm a chartered accountant. And I see the importance of records. And I saw why my mom didn't do well. And I saw why my mom ended up in that level.
Do you think age or gender is the reason why you cannot succeed as an entrepreneur? Here comes three books from the stable of Peter Osalo Books to change your mentality and help you succeed as an entrepreneur. All over the world, there are fewer and fewer jobs every year. Millions of people go to school and graduate and still cannot find jobs. The only way out is entrepreneurship, becoming your own boss. This solution has been recognized by world leaders like the United States President Barack Obama and many others. Entrepreneurship is the only way out of the economic crisis the world is facing. Teenage Entrepreneurs, a book that teaches teenagers the best time to start your own business. And for the 50-year-old and above, The 50-Year-Old Entrepreneur is a book that teaches you how to fulfill your dreams in your golden years. It is never too late. This book contains 200 businesses you can do at 50 and above. For women all over the world, the book Women Empowerment and Entrepreneurial Revolution, the solution for a prosperous society, poverty eradication and wealth creation. Empowerment is a must for women, and indeed, our world today without women's empowerment, we run the risks of doubling the population of the poor and stunting the growth and development of entire nations. What do we mean by empowering women? Find out in the book, Women Empowerment and Entrepreneurial Revolution, from the stables of Peter Osalo Books. To get these books, contact us at...
Century with information technology, with your WhatsApp, with your this now, you can't keep it going. It's like you're living in Stone Age. It's very, very poor, and I must tell you, it is not acceptable. You cannot be in any form of business again in this world, and you cannot write something down. You cannot write your record, or write who you sell to, do your business plan, do your cash flow forecast. This is the 21st century. I don't know anybody now that is not using a mobile phone. So if you're that smart to know that this is you use a mobile phone, you should be that smart to that these days that certain things you must do. Nobody now works on barefoot, or nobody that travels around the world with camera as they do those days. So we have really advanced. But in this part of bookkeeping, record keeping, we are still very, 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 very poor. The system now all over the world that Inland Revenue Services in America, they call it Inland Revenue Service. In UK, they call it Majesty Tax Service. In Nigeria, they call it Federal Inland Revenue Service. They are not coming so strong on everybody that if you don't keep your record, they can say these amount of taxes are owing and there's nothing you can do. So we shall teach you what is record keeping. What do you mean by keeping records? Then we will go to why. Then we will go to some definition of terms. And then we will not go to how. So it's a bit of a technical area that most people will not find interesting. It's not music, it's not Big Brother. Because that's the thing that you do too. But this is you have to sit down and think. In any category in this world, you must write something down. Even the Bible said it. I think it's in Habakkuk that you must write down your vision. You must write down your plans so that people can run wrong with it. It's the same thing. I've told you about my mom. As she lost so much money because people were owing that we were even denying and there was nothing she can do. My mom, I mean, I'm 63 years old. So you can imagine how old. My mom died 2014 at the age of 94. There were those, that time, they gave birth to them before the independence. And they were not exposed to what we are exposed to now. So I don't think as of today, nobody will be as backward as our grandparents were those days. So right now, you are a business. And you know why you are a business. You are a business because you want to earn a living. You are a business because you want to provide solutions to the people's needs. You are a business because you got to be fulfilled. You have been business because it's a passion to employ people. And you have become an employer. You have become an entrepreneur. It's a passion to be business and to be growing. But if you don't do this aspect of your business well, record keeping or bookkeeping, you cannot grow. You cannot grow in the sense that you cannot call in partners. One, you cannot even go to the bank for support. You cannot even know what you are doing yourself. Whether you, I met somebody just yesterday. She works in the National Assembly and she has a very big shop in Worcester 2. She drives a Toyota Camry. She has an MBA. She has two shops. But when I asked her some basic questions, I said, what is the quantity of the stock you're carrying? She doesn't know. I asked her again, how do you know you're making a lot of profit? She doesn't know. And how long have you been trading? I've been trading for about 9 years. And she said, okay, but is it because, yes, I'm suffering because every time I keep using money from my pocket to fund to put in the business, I don't take money out. So that is because she don't keep record. So she don't know whether she's doing well or she's not doing well. And that is very common in retailing. People that are, I told her that the most difficult business in this world is retailing, where it takes so much energy from you and pay you the least. So retailing is not, it's what most people want to do. Every child is in there and he's buying and selling, he's doing the retailing. But there's so much effort. So I now advise that please go to farming or go to a better business where you have more peace of mind, where the privilege will be low, where you can start improving on your music. And she was so happy. This is an MBA holder. Not that she doesn't even keep records. Not because you my niche. Those SMEs in Worcester to market now. Most of you don't even know what I'm doing. What is records? Even if you're a taxi driver, you're a cab driver, you must be able to write down how much you make every day. How much you buy, use about petrol every day? How much you use to repair the car every month? So at the end of the month, you can sit down to see, am I doing well or am I just wasting my time? So you must, record to me, it's like the air you breathe in. It's part of life, it's part of business, and it's something you must do. If you don't do it, you just hurt yourself. After I tell you that now, you now ask me, what do you mean by record keeping? Record keeping is writing down everything in this world. Okay, first of all, let me tell you about this book. You see the title of this book. I've been doing this business for about 30 years now. I've never written any book on accounts. But most SMEs, most business owners, their biggest problem is accounts. I've had seminars in England, even seminars in Port Harcourt, where we say accounts for non-accountants. I've had seminars for UWIN, where we taught the UWIN graduates account for non-accountants, how they must keep their bookkeeping.
You probably have never farmed before, but want to key into the agric revolution. Here is the practical manual you need to guide you as you venture into your agribusiness, The Farmer Entrepreneur, a practical guide to starting your agribusiness with 50 agribusiness ideas, co-ordered by Sani Dangote from the stable of Peter Osalo Books, to show you how to do a profitable agribusiness. Buy your copy at the following bookshops.
And all those things led me to write this book titled Bookkeeping and Accounts Made Simple for Owner Managed Businesses, for Students and for Young Entrepreneurs. In this book, I made it so simple for you from the word go. I started by telling you what are records, what are the definition of terms, because you might be hearing some buzzwords which we will cover during this period. Sales, cash, current assets, net assets, liabilities, share capital, this. I will tell you the meaning of all this, because you must know the term. All this I covered in this book. This book is the only first book I've written on account, and it's not written for accountants. It's written for owner managed businesses and for students and for SMEs. So please, whatever it takes you, get this copy of this book. It's going to make life easy. Try this month and March, I'm sure I'll be on this topic. And I'll be showing this book every day. You must get this book. Right. What do I now mean by record keeping? What's a record? First of all, you buy a notebook, a paper, a notebook. You can buy any notebook. On the notebook, you open the middle. You open the page to the side. On one side, you write expenses. That is what you are. It's debit. On the left side, this side of the book, you see me, you put on the head, expenses. That's what you are buying. What you are paying for the business. Don't include your personal expenses for your at home, because what you use for home is not for business. Then on the left hand side, you write sales, what you're making. That's the very basic. So on this left hand side, you can do it daily or weekly, for weekly or monthly, but it's better to do it daily so you don't forget. You start, say, 1st of February, you bought petrol, you bought this, you bought that, you put the amount. 2nd of February, you put amount. Then on the other side, if you're a taxi driver, what do you spend for your taxi? Maybe you pay rent for the taxi, or you repair the engine that day, that week. You buy petrol every day. You put them on the left hand side. Then on this left hand side, this left hand side, they call it debit side. I don't want to bother you with jack on now, but you call it left hand side. Because everything on earth has two sides. Like on earth, there's either man or woman. Man or woman. This life is either on or off. Life, you live, you live or you're dead. So account is two parts, simple. Either you're spending or you're getting. Yeah, either you are receiving something or you are giving something. So it's a two-sided conversation, it's so easy. That makes it very, very simple. It's like a man, this world, without anything more than male or female. So in accounts, we have two. Either you're an expense or your income. Either you're debit or your credit. Whether you're a profit or you're a loss. Whether you're a liability or your asset. Is two-way flow. So you make it very, very easy. So for the purpose of this very basic thing, please go and buy a notebook. Then open the notebook. This left-hand side, write expenses. Or what you buy, if you can write the word expenses. Then on this right-hand side, income, what you get in from the business. Or money from the bank, in case you went to the bank to take loan. It's something you are receiving. Whatever you receive, put it on this left-hand side. Then whatever you are spending, you are giving out, put it on this left-hand side and put it daily. And you suppose at the end of the month, when you sit down to calculate, you will not have an idea of what that month is. And please, let me not overflog it. If you are a business and you don't have a bank account, you need some kick on your backside or some slaps. How can you be in business and don't have a bank account? It's embarrassing. So the bank account, I'm not going to flog that because it's assumed you must have a bank account. That is basic. You must have a bank account. So in fact, I'm getting, this is getting stressing to me now. I don't want to stop, but let me just stop now for the break and then I'll get back to you after the break.
Now that you are about to start your business or that you are already in business, you need to keep track of how money comes into your business and how money goes out of your business. This book is a one-stop shop that will make you into an accountant to make sure that you keep your money intact. Get a copy of this book today and watch your business grow. From the stable of Peter Osalo Books, get this book at...
I've not even touched it, but what you can take home this week, just get an exercise book, open it, this left-hand side, expenses, or whatever you spend or give out, then the right-hand side, income, or whatever you receive, by, either from sales, or from friends, or you borrow from bank, and I said the bottom line, if you have a bad account, now please be so ashamed of yourself. If you're not ready, if you have a bad account to support you, how can you grow? How can you get low? How can you do this? So I don't think you must have a bad account, because this is everybody is talking about a lot on their phone. So it means you have a bad account. I will tell you how to put this together by next week. God bless you. This is success in your business. Our aim, our passion is to make you an entrepreneur, to enable to succeed in your business. Your success is our joy. And you can always call us on 080-9395-7238. 080-9395-7238. You can also WhatsApp us. You can send us email, successinyourbusiness.org or petersalo.org. There are so many books you are seeing. Please, you must buy some of the books and read. Mostly, don't miss this book. So I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.